You're watching Tag TV.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Karim Zimik, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give a glimpse of our country's diversity. Celebrated in the bright half of the Hindu lunar month of Ashwin, which typically falls in the Gregorian month of September and October, Navratri is one of the most revered festivals in Hinduism. Though observed in different ways and different reasons across the country, the core reason behind the celebration remains the same: victory of good over evil. So today, let's take you to soak your senses in this year's Navratri celebrations.
Millions of Hindus offered prayers in temples and observed fast across India as they observed the nine-night Navratri festival. Dedicated to all the nine forms of Goddess Durga, the festival is celebrated across the country with lot of vigor and passion, and each region observing it in a different manner. In several states, especially in West Bengal, it is celebrated as Durga Puja, which is a five-day-long extravaganza. Pandals of Goddess Durga with different themes are erected across these states. This year in Kolkata, organizers erected a pandal dedicated to 200 years of Bengal Renaissance, wherein the goddess was presented in the form of book. There were also portraits of various personalities of the Renaissance with a bookshelf dedicated to each of them. Similarly, in Mumbai, organizers avoided using non-degradable material harmful to the environment and instead did the decorations with tiny, colorful lights.
हमने ये सोचा कि इस बार हमारा एक environmental friendly concept रहे, जिसमें हमारी जो देवी की मूर्ति है, वो 100% environment friendly है, जो clay से बनाई गई है। हमारा जो ये डेकोरेशन का कॉन्सेप्ट है, ये हमने साउथ कलकत्ता में जो बंगाली देवी का सेलिब्रेशन या कॉन्सेप्ट होता है, वो हमने मुंबई में फर्स्ट टाइम लाए।
A unique devotion was seen in the city of Amritsar, where thousands of devotees who are blessed with a baby lined up at a temple devoted to Hindu god Hanuman to express their gratitude. It is believed after the fulfillment of their wish of a child, couples offer prayers for all 9 days of Navratri by masquerading their son as Langur, and then on 10th day, the clothes of children are removed and they are given a bath. In western state of Gujarat, the lively atmosphere wrapped its cities as locals performed Garba, a folk dance, to their heart's content, wearing colorful and shiny dresses as an orchestra played on the stage.
बस अभी गरबा खेलने मिल रहा है, वही बहुत बड़ी बात है। अभी परमिशन मिलने गई है, वो अच्छा है कोविड के बाद। अब माता जी हमें वो इसे आशीर्वाद करेगी, अब नेक्स्ट ईयर से पूरी तरह से हम कर सके गरबा, और ये कोविड जैसी चीज पूरी तरह से चली जाए।
In Telangana, Navratri was observed in a form of a colorful floral festival known as Batukamma, which is basically a beautiful flower stack arranged with different unique seasonal flowers, mostly with medicinal value. As a part of the festival, women for all the 9 days gather in large numbers in an open area where they form a circle around Batukamma and start singing folk songs by clapping their hands and making synchronizing steps in unison. This year, the governor of the state, Tamilisai Soundararajan, organized the festival in a grand manner at Rajbhavan and celebrated it along with people from different backgrounds.
Really very happy. This Telangana is emotionally and traditionally attached to Badukama. And 3 days we are celebrating in Rajbhavan. Yesterday, Rajbhavan Parivar. Actually, I gifted them my personal sarees to them, and we all participated yesterday. And today, writers, doctors, and professionals are participating. Tomorrow, celebrities may participate. So this is a traditional and a healthy program, Goddess of Health. So in this corona period, we want to convey the message, everyone should be hale and healthy, and women empowerment should be there, and everyone should take their vaccination. That is my message.
The festival holds immense importance in Hinduism, as it is believed that during Navratri, Goddess Durga descends on earth to rid it of demons and bless her devotees with happiness and prosperity.
India is a land of diversity where various religions and traditions are knitted together so perfectly, making it one of the most beautiful amalgamations of various cultural identities. Amid all the faiths mixing with one another, Sufism is one of the most important parts of Indian culture that promotes love, harmony, and humanity. So today we take you to the shrine of Sayyid Sultan Moinuddin Shah Qadri, which has been serving as a symbol of religious harmony for years.
Apart from being a rich reservoir of minerals and natural resources, the Deccan region has also acted as a place where Sufism has flourished in its true spread. The entire region is abundant with shrines of Sufi saints that not only propagated the teachings of these great saints, but also play a major role in bringing together people of different castes and religions. One such shrine is that of Sayyid Sultan Moinuddin Shah Qadri, which is thronged by people of all faiths, especially during the annual Urs of the saint.
सब लोग आते हैं यहाँ के उर्स के मौकों पर जितने भी हिंदू मुस्लिम वगैरह जो जो भी लोग हैं यहाँ के और बाहर के जो भी लोग हैं ज़ायरीन के लिए आने का कोई ये नहीं है आते हैं बिला मजहब व मिल्लत आते हैं.
Well known in the region for his miracles and his devotion towards Allah, the saint is believed to be born in the year 1083 AH according to the Islamic calendar in Iraq. He came to India during Shah Jahan's reign and steadily started gaining popularity for his noble deeds. It is said that the saint had 1,000 acres of land in his possession and always donated land to people in need. Saint throughout his life worked for the betterment of the society, and it is believed that nobody returns empty-handed from his dargah.
Awam ko ye batate the, khandan ko ye batate the ki aap jo hai duniya se raghbat bahut kam rakhna, jitni zarurat hai utna rakhna, to Hazrat ko apne inaam bhi mila, magar kabhi inaam ki zameenon ki wagaira koi parwah nahi karte the. सैयद पाशा शाह कादरी कम से कम 1,000 acres ज़मीन पर काश्त वगैरह भी किए उन्होंने, और जो भी जिसको भी तकलीफ मंद थी या ज़रूरतमंद थे उन लोगों को बसाते गए.
Since ages, Sufi saints like Sayyid Sultan Moinuddin Shah Qadri have propagated the message of spiritualism and harmony in our country, and their teachings are still playing a significant role in strengthening the threat of secularism.
Now now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Apple orchard owners in Jammu and Kashmir are looking for profits as they expect a decent apple harvest this year. Going by the plentiful produce of the early varieties of apples, the orchard owners are ecstatic as they hope to reap a rich dividend this season.
इस टाइम भी मतलब हम गांदरबल से हैं तो यहाँ से भी मतलब बहुत सारे ऐसे मतलब सेब निकलते हैं जिसकी वजह से ये थोड़ा माना जाना इसका तो मेन जो है वो शुपियन है शुपियन से भी बहुत सारे ज़्यादा अच्छे सेब निकलते हैं तो इस टाइम सेब का ये सीज़न चल रहा है तो सेब उतार रहे हैं
पिछले साल थोड़ा ठीक ही था इस साल बारिश की वजह से थोड़ा कम ही रह गया था शुक्र अल्लाह का जो भी है तो ठीक ही है ये यहाँ से बेचते हैं हम दिल्ली भी बेचते हैं मुंबई भी बेचते हैं बेंगलोर भी बेचते हैं जिधर चाहेंगे वहाँ बेच सकते हैं
Kashmir along with Himachal Pradesh is known as the apple bowl of India. These two states are the major apple producing region of the country. It is the mainstay of the local economy with hundreds of rural people eking out their livelihood from this industry. What came as a daily musing turned into a full-time calling for a Mumbai-based social worker when she started conducting open mobile classes for underprivileged children. 25-year-old Hemanti Sen heads to Skywalk at Kandivali railway station in Mumbai by 3 p.m. and the children start gathering. They spread a rug, sit with their notebooks and enthusiastically learn the names of vegetables in Hindi, English and Marathi languages.
पेरेंट्स भी इनको पढ़ाई में हेल्प नहीं कर सकते विच विल बी डिफिकल्ट फॉर देम टू कोप इन स्कूल तो इसके वजह से हम उनको वो सपोर्ट भी देते हैं हम उनको डेली खाना देते हैं जो भी बच्चों की मेडिकल नीड्स हो क्योंकि अभी वेदर के वजह से बहुत सारे बच्चों को स्किन इन्फेक्शन हो रहा है तो हम उनको मेडिकल एड प्रोवाइड करते हैं लॉकडाउन में हमने उनको राशन भी दिया तो वट एवर वी वॉन्ट टू क्रिएट एन एनवायरमेंट जहाँ पे ये बच्चे बड़े होके दे कैन बी एक्सेप्टेड एज अ पार्ट ऑफ आर सोसाइटी
When Sen took the initiative in 2018, she was alone with no funds, but only a passion to bring opportunities to the children who could not afford to look beyond a meal of two times. More volunteers eventually joined Sen, and she aptly named her group as Junoon, the Urdu word for passion. The group continues their support to the children after they are accepted at schools as their parents can't help in their studies. Since Junoon group now it's nearly 70 such underprivileged children with their education spread across four centers including Kandivali one.
Living in communal harmony is natural to Indians. For times immemorial, India has given wide space to its countrymen to practice diverse faiths and religions. Example of this peaceful coexistence could be seen at every nook and corner of the country. Today we take you to witness two such examples where Muslims have been contributing to the Hindu festival of Navratra. Take a look.
India is a country where religious harmony and peaceful coexistence have prospered in its true spirit and have become the identity of its citizens. Examples of this harmonious bond are seen on a day-to-day basis in different regions of the country. One such example is from Godhra city of Gujarat, where Muslim artisans have been making dandiyas for Hindu festival of Navratri for years.
Godhra में मुस्लिम समाज के 80 साल से ये काम का चल रहा है और यहाँ के डांडिये पूरे देश और दुनिया में प्रख्यात है जो नौतक और नवरात्रि का पर्व त्यौहार होता है तो गोधरा शहर के मुस्लिम कारीगर और दुकान वाले वो बहुत कलात्मक बनाते हैं और कौमी एकता के लिए भी वो एक बहुत बड़ी बात है गोधरा के अंदर और इससे पूरे गोधरा के 200 से ऊपर कारीगर दूसरे जो बनाने के जो कारखाने हैं और जो व्यापारी जो यहाँ से ले जाते बेचते उनको भी बहुत फायदा होता था।
About 18 inches long, dandiyas are wooden sticks made of mango or bawal wood, covered with colorful laces and decorative items, and are widely used in dandiya and garba dances during different festivals like Navratra. The dandiyas made in Gothra are supplied all over the country. Meanwhile, in Meerut city of Uttar Pradesh, Muslim artisans have been making effigies of Demon King Ravan that are burnt on the Hindu festival of Dashehra. Five generations of these Muslim families have been making these effigies as a gesture of long-gone religious harmony between the two communities.
भेदभाव वाली कभी बात ही नहीं हुई, ना मेरे को ऐसा आदमी मिला जो भेदभाव दिखाए। हमने सन बयासी में बिल्कुल कर्फ्यू लगा हुआ था शहर के अंदर, निकलने थे लेकिन हिम्मत नहीं थी, लेकिन हमने यहाँ बैठ के काम किया। नहीं नहीं कभी हमें ऐसा महसूस नहीं हुआ कि भेदभाव वाली कोई बात हो, बहुत संयोग मिला हमें यहाँ से, लोग भी हमारा मान करते हैं और हम इनका करते हैं।
India has always had many examples of how different people live together in harmony. And these Muslim artisans are one of them.
And now we will take you to Koraput district of Odisha, where recently a competition was organized to promote the traditional art of jhoti or alpona, a colorful mural drawn at the doorstep during festivals. Take a look. Traditional arts are a visual representation of a region's culture. With the rapidly increasing urbanization and modernization taking place, there comes a need of preserving and popularizing these art forms. One such art form is that of jhoti, an Odissi folk art where women folk draw colorful patterns outside their homes during festivals for decoration. In order to revive the traditional folk art and encourage more women to practice it, a competition was recently organized in Badampur village of Odisha's Koraput district. It was attended by world-renowned sand artist Sudarshan Patnaik, who appreciated the efforts of the authorities.
During the COVID-19, हम लोगों ने ये concept सोचा कि पहले रघुराजपुर में किए हम लोगों ने कि वहाँ पर entire गांव ने उनकी दरवाजा पे painting किया, तो उसके बाद ये हमारा concept था कि कोरापुट का ये जो पद्मपुर गांव है, इस गांव में 112 पार्टिसिपेंट जिनकी घर का दरवाजे पे ही उन लोगों ने इतनी अच्छी तरह से माँ और बहनों के सब झूठी चित्र अंकन किए हैं, ये एक बहुत बड़ा प्राइड है कि उनके अंदर जो टैलेंट है वो टैलेंट्स को और आगे लेने के लिए ये कंपटीशन किया जा रहा है। उसको स्पेशली हम लोग तीन स्पेशल प्राइजेस भी दे रहे हैं और उसके बाद हम यही टैलेंट को और स्टेट लेवल पे भी उसको लेंगे।
Organized by the Odisha Lalit Kala Academy in collaboration with Koraput District Administration, the competition saw a number of women drawing murals or rangoli at their doorstep. Winners of the competition were felicitated with awards. It is through events and competitions like these that even today these traditional art forms are alive and are continuously prospering.
Next, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section World in Focus.
Japanese silver grass is a landscape symbol during autumn in Japan. It is the landfill oversight of Yatazawa disposal site in Hinode town of Tokyo, and now the original scenery is full of nature.
It is home to many precious creatures and insects. Tokyo Metropolitan Government is responsible for thorough management and preservation of the regenerated natural environment. It used to be a landfill for incinerated ash and waste from nearby municipalities.
埋め立ての時期にですね、動植物が減少した時期もございまして、これを補うためにですね、ある区画に草原や清流復活用の貯水池を設けたということで、その回復が図られてきております。希少な生き物たち、国鳥と呼ばれるオオムラサキというのがございますが、それらをはじめ、水辺を好むトンボや鳥類なども増えてございます。
A sports ground will be built in the area for the citizens. The Futat Suzuka disposal site is a managed final disposal site equipped with the highest level of facility and system in Japan and carries out thorough safety management. The facility is to dispose incineration ash and non-combustible waste fragments from nearby municipal waste disposal plants and converts them into cement. This cement is called eco-cement because it can be reused and is useful for town development with many advantages. The Tokyo Metropolitan Government's eco-cement project contributes to recycling society and conservation of nature through the reuse of incineration ash. Crowds of people stream past robot Xavier, who is patrolling the streets of Singapore on police duty, ready to issue out warnings or advisories for those who behaved in an uncivil manner. Developed by Singapore's Home Team Science and Technology Agency, the robot with seven eyes or cameras rolls along on four wheels. Two of the autonomous robots went on patrol in September, monitoring a busy shopping and residential area for bad behavior. The robots were designed to also be on the lookout for illegal smoking and gatherings, which exceed the current COVID-19 group size limits. Singapore authorities have said that during the trial, the robots would be used for surveillance and displaying messages to educate the public on proper behavior and would not be used for law enforcement. Casio's popular watch company G-Shock has released a new watch that incorporates the trends of the times. It syncs up with the world trend of gender-free. It is an early type of G-Shock, a best-selling watch that has made G-Shock's name known all over the world. This type is designed to change this early type of G-Shock to a metal-covered timepiece. Both watches have a different atmosphere from the traditional wild G-Shock design.
G-Shockってもともとファッションのトレンドを追ったデザインを中心に展開しているんですけれども、近年社会の風潮的にジェンダーレスって言われているように、男性が女性のものをつけたりですとか、女性が男性の洋服着たりですとかっていうのが当たり前のような世の中になってきている中で、時計にもその価値を持たせてもいいんじゃないかなっていうところから、このラインが誕生しました。
Casio's watch is popular all over the world because of their unique design and tough, high-quality products. The total number of quality assessment specifications is 195. G-Shock has repeatedly developed advanced functional tests for shock-resistant and waterproof watches. Casio has detailed data of shipping countries. It covers each country's citizens' preference, including male and female, young and adult. G genderless G-Shock is satisfactory for everyone all over the world.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at mind@anin.com. I'm your host, Skyrim, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.